We're going to go ahead and get started. My name is Greg Gamble, and I am a landscape architect and land planner consultant to Holiday Properties. This is a required meeting by the City of Franklin when a development plan is being proposed, either new or for revision. And this is a recorded meeting. There are several ways that we ask that you communicate with us tonight, and all of the communication is documented and recorded. The first is, if you'd like to speak, you can unmute yourself. The second is you can open up the chat bar and type any comments or questions that you may have in the chat. We will do our best to run through those comments or questions that you may have, and we want to give everybody ample time to get your responses. What I'd like to ask is that we go ahead and go through the full presentation, and if you have a thought or a question during the presentation, add it to the chat, and we'll come back to the very beginning of that and kind of work our way through. And if you have questions that you'd like to ask at the end of the presentation, there will be plenty of time for us to address those. We have Alan Arender and Benton Smothers, both with Holiday Properties, part of the meeting tonight with us, to tell you a little bit about their plans and Holiday's vision for the factory. We have several aldermen that have also joined us, and neighbors, and I really want to say thank you all for taking time out of your night tonight to join us. The City of Franklin provides us with a list of all neighbors that are within 500 feet of the property line. So if you were notified by letter, you are one of those neighbors. And so we appreciate you taking time to join us. Benton, I'll hand it over to you. Feel free to unmute yourself, and you can kind of introduce Holiday.
Yeah, actually, Alan's going to take this one. I'll see you control.
Yeah, well, say hello. Greg said, everybody, thanks for joining. We're very excited about getting this phase of the project in front of the community. And a little bit about, you've probably seen a lot of activity in the news and things that are happening. And we're really excited, certainly recognize the treasure that the factory is to the Franklin and really to the region. And you know, a little bit on my background. I've been in Nashville about 16 years, and have done a variety of redevelopment all around the area. And when we have tracked and watched the factory over the years, and always felt like this was a tremendous opportunity, a great fit for us, and the vision that we think we have for the project. And, you know, certainly recognizing the history and emotional connection that all the community has to the property. And, you know, we are seeking to set it up for the next 50 years and continue to draw that community to the property and hear the stories and create the memories for the next several decades. But what you're about to see tonight is really one of the first things we noticed when we started looking at the factory is how inwardly focused everything was. You really had to go inside to do anything. And I would say tonight, the development plan that's in front of you tonight is the first step of what we see opening this up to the outside, really creating some new nodes and activating outdoor areas that visitors in the community can enjoy. So with that, I'll let Greg and team kind of take it over and start stepping through the plan.
Thank you, Alan. First I'll walk you through the existing zoning and what Envision Franklin, our land use plan, says for the property. The zoning for the property today is PD district, which is a planned district. The planned district is used when a master plan is created, adopted by the board, mayor, and alderman, and that plan becomes the zoning for the entire campus. So that's what's in place for the factory today. Envision Franklin identifies this property as neighborhood commercial, and that includes uses such as institutional, local commercial, professional, and transitional office and recreation. This is the existing approved development plan or plan development for the factory. And it includes permitted uses for retail, restaurant, office, event venue, and it has entitlements for 4 residential apartments. The City of Franklin, Central Franklin Overlay District does apply for this property, as well as the Historic Preservation Overlay. So any approvals that we gain with any site plan approval or architecture elevation changes or even the development plan itself require either approval from Historic Zoning Commission or recommendation by the Historic Zoning Commission to the Planning Commission. There are several improvements that we're making to the factory campus that are permitted today without development plan revision, without development plan approval. And we are seeking several site changes that are outside of the development plan, but I still want to show you the full scope of work that we've been discussing as a design team and as Holiday Properties, so that you can see all of the changes that are being proposed for the factory campus. The City of Franklin is currently under construction with a pedestrian walkway along Franklin Road. Today, there are no pedestrian connections to the factory from Franklin Road or Liberty Pike. In order to get from these sidewalks out here, you have to walk across the parking lots to get to the factory. We want to make vast improvements on the pedestrian circulation here on the campus. So we have the new sidewalk that's going in on Franklin Road. One of the first things we want to do is remove the parking spaces that are here along Mafiosa's and replace it with a very generous and wide pedestrian sidewalk that accesses the front of the factory. Today, there is no pedestrian connection along this side of the factory. And so we want to add that pedestrian circulation all the way around this side. We're introducing a new automotive drop-off for guests or for, it could be for Uber pickup or valet parking during special times, but adding a new pedestrian drop-off there, vehicular drop-off. Right now along Franklin Road, there is very, very little landscape within this parking lot. And as a result of that, there's a lot of heat island effects. So we're bringing in new landscape areas to this parking lot so that we can get more parking lot trees added to the parking lot area. We're proposing to make some changes around the water tower, and I'll walk through those in just a minute. And we are proposing to complete this pedestrian connection back over here in front of Honest Coffee. Right now, there are a lot of places along this side of the parking lot where if the car creeps over the sidewalk, it almost covers completely the sidewalk. So we want to make a wider sidewalk there so that we have better pedestrian circulation. We're adding 2 pedestrian connections to Liberty Pike in this location. So really trying to make it a lot easier for pedestrians to access the building. Currently, the farmer's market is located at the back of the building. And on Saturday mornings, this parking lot here becomes full while other parking lots around the factory remain relatively empty. Also, on Saturday mornings, typically this area here along the back of the factory is not very active. There is some activity in the main hall, but they're very disjointed. And we want to bring that farmer's market to a location where it has a much better connection with those things that are happening inside the more active areas of the factory. So we are proposing to relocate the farmer's market to this area here along Liberty Pike. This area here could be closed off during a Saturday morning and would allow for more people to park in convenient locations around the factory campus to get to the farmer's market. It also allows for better exposure for the farmer's market so that more people can see, and it eliminates this conflict over here with vehicles that are oftentimes stacked up down the road. It now gives multiple access points for people to get into the factory, to park close to the farmer's market, to walk through the factory to access the farmer's market location. So we see that as a great improvement. There are four areas around the factory that we are proposing to add new hardscape elements to and start to create a more exterior outside environment. The first three that I'll talk about, we are proceeding forward with design changes. Those are permitted with just site plan approval. So those don't require a development plan amendment. The first, again, is at this entrance. I'm going to zoom in a little bit here so you can see and read a little bit better. Holiday Properties is proposing two new restaurants along this side of the building. And for those restaurants, we are creating an area for outdoor patio dining. We have an area just off of the patio dining that is a raised wood deck area. We want to save these cypress trees that are growing in this courtyard. And to do that, we are building up a platform that won't disturb the root structure of those trees, but still allows for people to have some more private lounge areas outside to enjoy the space underneath the tree canopy. We have a great love for the Rusty statue that's over in front of Honest Coffee, and think this would be an excellent opportunity to bring in some more sculptural, creative factory style sculptures into this space, and want to find some artwork that really resonates with the history of the factory. We have an opportunity here behind Mafiosis to create a more Italianate style outdoor dining area. And we have some formal sitting for the drop-off area. So as you're waiting on a ride or you're waiting on valet, that you have a place that you can kind of stage before your car arrives. Around the water tower, we have a new restaurant that's being proposed on this side of the main entrance to the factory. And this area here would be outdoor dining that would be specific to this restaurant. There is a retaining wall that curves around the water tower in this location. That retaining wall will stay where it is. And we will have a new hardscape and landscape around the water tower and underneath the water tower. This area underneath the water tower would really be used and would be accessible by people who are at the farmer's market, who may grab something from the food truck and want to come and sit. at one of the picnic tables and eat, or if you want to grab tacos from Mojo Tacos and come outside, you can come over on this side. This is not an area that is serviced by a restaurant, but allows for more casual seating, allows for more lounge space. We have a large 16-person table that is directly underneath the water tower that just provides a different experience. We have a new restaurant that's being proposed here at Building 13. For reference, this is Honest Coffee right here. And so we're providing a new outdoor dining area for the new restaurant. We are keeping Honest Coffee's outdoor patio, and that's located here for reference. This is the main entrance that comes in right adjacent to their shop. We have some existing hardscape. It's kind of concrete. It's broken in a lot of places, and we want to convert that to pavers. This is rusty here. Rusty here, and we'd like to add more landscape to provide a little bit more of a kind of a base or grounding for him. Add some more seating and benches around that landscape to provide more seating opportunities. We want to open this other area up a little bit more for use. And here we're showing some lounge seating, maybe a fire pit in this location, so that it becomes more active and becomes more of a usable space than it is today. These photographs represent a lot of the character images that we have been using to articulate the design of these spaces. And that includes the hardscape materials, the soft turf areas around the water tower. Here in blue, we're adding a water fountain so that when you're sitting on these the steps, you have the sound of falling water, but it also kind of resonates with the water tower itself and its history and purpose here on the factory campus. So we are asking for a development plan revision, and this neighborhood meeting is required as a part of any revision to a development plan. The development plan revision includes the addition of a carousel building and a commercial recreation use. That building is located right here, and I'll go into more detail on this courtyard and what's happening around Mockingbird Theater. It addresses distribution of refuse areas, addresses cross-access connectivity, and addresses the creation of a comprehensive signage plan for the whole campus. Ken Means is an artist and a sculptor. You may have seen his work walking through the halls of the factory. He had a small shop where he would display his sculptures for the carousel, but he's never had a place to put them. And Holiday Properties would like to build him a carousel building where they can locate these sculptures that he's created for. Carousel building is designed to resonate with the factory. It is not designed to look historic. It's designed to look as though it's built in current modern day, but is built with historic, timeless materials. It will have garage doors that can open up on a nice day or close if there's weather or if the carousel is closed for some reason. I'll zoom in on this courtyard. So when you walk out of the factory today in this area, it really feels more like a back of house delivery area. And we would like to transform that into a usable pedestrian space. We see this area here as an interactive play area, maybe with cornhole, with games that the kids can play and interact. On the corner of the factory here today, there's a metal shed. We'd like to remove that shed and replace that with an outdoor courtyard area with a fireplace that can be viewed from two sides. So a double-sided fireplace there. There is a metal canopy that stretches out across from the factory today and provides weather shelter to access this building. Just below that, we're planning on adding another lounge area for retailers, for office users, to have that outdoor experience as well. Today, when you come in off the parking lot, there is a kind of an circular staircase that comes down to Mockingbird Theater. We would like to remove that circular staircase and have more of a grand staircase alongside the brick wall here. That allows us to create pedestrian connections back over to the carousel building, as well as back over to the Mockingbird Courtyard. In the Mockingbird Courtyard, we're planning to have a hammock garden for lounging, additional benches that will be added that will be permanent, additional plaza space that will have some umbrella tables and chairs. And we want to rebuild this stage so that it feels a little bit more permanent and connected to the Mockingbird Theater. So another modification of standards request that we're making is to address how these refuse containers or garbage containers are handled on the property. Today, there are three locations where dumpsters are located out in the parking lot area. Prior to 2020, probably about 2019, there were two additional dumpsters that were located along Liberty Pike, and again, just kind of out in the parking lot. There's no screening for those. And because we're adding restaurants in these locations and in this location here in Honest Coffee, we really need to have some refuse containers that are very nicely done, respectful of the view corridor along Liberty Pike, but also easily accessible by these restaurants. And so we're proposing new container areas located in these four locations that are shown on this map. They will all be designed with brick wall structures that completely enclose these container areas. And then on the outside of the brick walls, we plan on having a live green screen that will then just seamlessly transition into the landscape that is along Liberty Pike and or located alongside the back of the property here. So trying to really tie that landscape together and hide and screen those refuse areas. Currently, the city of Franklin does not allow for these containers to be located on the front or along the side of a building. But we really see the factory as unique. It would be very difficult for containers to be taken all the way across and around the building to dispose of trash or inappropriately hauled, you know, through the building. And we realize now that that's the reason why these previous dumpsters were located out here on Liberty Pike. We just want to do it in a better way, in a more sensitive way. The city of Franklin requires cross connectivity to any property that is alongside its property boundary. Today, there are two connection points that already exist. One of those is here, and that connection point accesses all the way up to Harpeth Industrial Court. There's another access point that's here connected to this drive that connects up to Harpeth Industrial Court. If we met the current requirements of the City of Franklin standards, we would have to have 10 to 11 points of connection along this road for these buildings and their parking lots. We'd like to create a more purposeful and more intentional connectivity plan where we identify two or three points of access for future connections along this drive aisle. And so that requires a special consideration, a modification of standards to be approved by the board, mayor, and aldermen and planning commission. We talked briefly about establishing a master plan for signage for the factory. We have submitted that master plan to the Historic Zoning Commission for review. There are several aspects of the signage master plan that require some special consideration by the board and mayor and aldermen. And it's important that we talk about each modification of standards at our neighborhood meetings. So I want to walk you through this real quick. This is probably a little bit more technical than the design elements of the master plan, but still important to talk about. Currently, the City of Franklin requires that all signs not be irregular shapes. We have some tenants in the factory who want a little bit more creativity. And as you know, just by walking through the factory, there's some quirkiness to it. There's some special pipes that are hanging out on the outside of the building that really don't have a purpose anymore, but they're part of its character. And so we want to play off on that. And so as a part of that, we want a modification of standards to allow the signage to be a bit more creative, to have some special shapes to it. There are several of the factory exterior walls that really only have one or two main entrances. And those main entrances access the main hall, the access the interior, almost mall corridor. And as a result of that, we would be limited to only one sign per door under the current regulations. But we would like to have the opportunity to have some locations where we have multiple sign bands to advertise multiple tenants that are within the building. There's not a lot of very good wayfinding in the factory. There's not a lot of very good acknowledgement of what shops or stores or what's inside the factory. And so we want to do a much better job about articulating to the community at large what's in there. What shops are in there, what stores are in there. So there are some locations too where we would like to have canopy signs. These canopy signs would really be more about advertising or talking about the factory itself. These would be not necessarily specific to individual tenants. We're asking for a modification of standards to allow one projecting sign per tenant along the same facade. This does not mean that a tenant will have a band sign and a projecting sign. What it means is that we have different conditions around the factory in the various buildings that are around the factory. And in some locations, we may have two or three hanging signs. In some locations, we may have two or three band signs. So it's not about over-signing a business. It's about providing various opportunities and options for a business to tell you, hey, we're in here too. So that applies here as well to the vertical signs. We're requesting that vertical signs be allowed on a building that is less than two stories in height. Currently, there's a maximum that's a minimum that's applied there. You have to be at least two stories to have a vertical blade sign. We have some areas of the factory that are one story, but they're tall. And we believe that we can appropriately design and apply a blade sign in those locations for those businesses. In this modification of standards, we are requesting to address situations where there are multiple tenants within the same building, but each has a specific entrance. And currently, you would not be allowed to have multiple wall signs for those businesses. We also believe that we're going to have to ask for a modification of standards to repaint the factory logo on the water tower. We are still working with staff to determine whether or not that modification of standards will be required. This is the logo for the factory at Franklin that Holiday Properties is proposing. So a little bit different than what you may have seen in the historic factory at Franklin water tower logo, but it's just a fresh new look to a new brand for the factory. So our next step is an initial submittal on June the 13th and anticipating a planning commission meeting on July 28th. Following the planning commission meeting on July 28th, we would then proceed to the board and mayor and alderman meetings. And we don't quite know that schedule yet, but if you, a lot of you have my email now, you're welcome to email me at any point in time and ask me for an update on the schedule for the factory. So at this point, I can go back to any slide that we've shown. We've got a few questions here. Benton and Alan, if you want to unmute, you can help us answer a question. The first is Carol Ann's Carousel in Cincinnati would be a good reference for the new carousel building. We appreciate that, and we'll take note of that. We'll look at it for sure. And then it would be cool if most of the signs were enamel signs in a variety of shapes and structures. But by being enamel, it is linked to all of the enamel stoves that were built at the factory. I think that's a great idea that start to tie some of the history of the factory. Ben and Alan, any thoughts so far?
Yeah, those are good. That's all great input. We have been looking around at a variety of carousel options and working with Ken and his family about how do we make this work. And you know, think that like you talk about that the one in Cincinnati really resonating, we think that the same opportunities here. I think this can really be something that that people gravitate to and are excited to come to the factory to see.
If you have a question you want to ask, you feel free to unmute yourself as well. You don't have to type everything in. Alderman Pott says, would like to see several logo options for the water tower. Al, any thoughts on that? Where we stand?
Yeah, so this, what you see here is not necessarily what is going to be requested for approval. We're working with Historic on what that is. That is the new logo for the factory. And that is what we hope in some form that we're able to put up there.
The intention is to paint it the rust red.
Yeah. I was gonna say, get it. We recognize the, and we think it looked better that color as well. And, but bringing in that logo is part of it.
We have a question here. Is the shed planned for removal and will the smokestack remain?
The smokestack certainly will remain. We've been through some engineering of that to test its integrity and see if there's repairs that need to be made, but it will be there. The shed on the back, we don't know yet. We haven't gotten there on a decision on that.
I will say it's not shown in this image, but the pump house that exists underneath the water tower is proposed to remain and be a part of the plan for underneath that area.
I say that there's a comment about the intention of the space after removal of the concrete area outside I assume that's where Franklin Juice is relocated. That is a temporary relocation while they build out their new spot next to Honest Coffee inside the factory. But that the intention of that space is to make a connection into Liberty Hall and really be an extension of that event space where we could have an indoor-outdoor component in that area.
Yeah, you're talking about here at this point.
I think the question is about building 10, Greg. It was the last slide.
Last slide. We have a big white parcel. Yeah, there's a big white block there
At one time there was a greenhouse on that concrete pad.
Right there.
Yeah.
Just below that there's, I think that's the question.
Yeah. Yeah. The idea is to have, is to activate that, with a new hardscape. We just haven't gotten to the design there yet.
Any other questions or thoughts or comments or? We've got a question. Ben and Alan, can you speak a little bit to the pros and cons that the farmers market vendors may have made about relocating to the area along Liberty Pike versus where they are now?
Yeah, there's dialogue with them about how that works longer term. We're working through some scenarios with them of how that fits, how functionally it continues to work for them. I can't say that we've got it all resolved yet, but it's part of a conversation and dialogue with them of how do we make that work.
So it's still an ongoing conversation. And
That's right.
Will the existing landscape throughout the parking areas be revitalized?
Yes.
Yes, that's the intent. And that's why we're proposing not only a new landscape in the parking lot along Franklin Road, which is so deficient, but also along Liberty Pike. There are some really nice magnolias that are along Liberty Pike right now that we're proposing to potentially relocate, spread out along Liberty Pike a little bit more, give them more room to grow, kind of refresh the landscape plans for sure.
Right now, the landscaping is concentrated in areas that's blocking visibility of the buildings too. And so the plan here is to spread that out a little bit, add trees in the parking lots, decrease that heat island effect that Greg's talking about. But relocating some of the magnolias along Liberty Pike helps to open up the visibility of these old buildings too, and something we definitely want to celebrate.
Can you talk a little bit about your timeline, maybe in phasing, how you see construction activity taking place around the factory?
Yeah, I think what you've seen inside has gotten started. If you've been there in the last week, you'll see that we've separated the main hall area where the first phase of big interior renovations start. We hope to start on these exterior renovations by the fall. Again, it's part of this approval step and getting the sign-offs here will dictate that. I would expect that this exterior work that's outlined here is a good 12 months of duration to see all that through.
We had another question here about the farmers market. Will similar roofing be installed for rain, sun coverage, and what's currently available? And we're still working with city staff on that as to what could be supported, what could be approved. And that is a part of the conversation with the farmers market. So I don't quite have an answer on that yet. And it's not a part of the development plan revision at this time. So will the rail cars remain?
We're working on several ideas with the rail cars. We hope to keep them on the site. We hope to use them in a few different ways. That's another thing working through with planning on what we can be allowed to do with those and how to utilize them.
Any other questions, comments? Well, if not, we have one more. Any changes to the use more, any changes to use more directional lighting to decrease light pollution?
Yeah, we're working with a lighting consultant right now, looking at all of these in connection with Greg and his landscape architecture team, looking at how we light the exterior of the buildings. Certainly is an important architectural component of what we're looking at here. So more to come on that, but yeah, absolutely, we're studying all of that.
These are great questions. I don't want to cut anybody off. If you're noodling on something or you want to say something, please do. Otherwise, we'll wrap up here in just a few minutes if there are no other questions. All right. Well, thank you all very much for joining us tonight. We really appreciate it. And look forward to you staying tuned while we move forward to the city's process. Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.